10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Geneva. We are at the Cadavre Velodrome Stadium in the heart of Geneva for this very special night, One Night with Stars, where some of the badminton players have made the trip to Switzerland for the first ever badminton concert. All the benefits are going to a charity foundation called Solibad, Badminton Without Borders, and you will see the best badminton shuttlers: Peter Gade, Nathan Robertson, Simon Santoso, Yong, Park Ju, Bong, Pi Hongyan, Agnese, Allegrini, Jeanine, Cicognini and Matthias are here tonight for an amazing show, unique in the world of badminton. We will start with the men singles for this incredible evening. And the first player to come on court is no other than one of the best Indonesian players, Simon Santoso, who is number 2 in Indonesia, behind Taufik Hidayat. Here he comes. Great, great young player from Indonesia, Simon Santoso. Young and coming up player, but he's been around for quite some time. He has the experience of high-level badminton. He's been in the shadow of Taufik for some years now, but he's starting to play at his best. He's been a runner-up last year at the Denmark Open and has won many tournaments back home in Indonesia. One of the young and uprising players. And his opponent tonight will be the number one from Denmark, Peter Gade. He has won many titles. He's been on a circuit for more than 15 years. These players know each other very well, of course. They've met each other many times. And he's welcome as a star here in Geneva. 1,000 people are here tonight in the heart of Switzerland for this very special evening. And the two players will be warming up for a few minutes before starting their performance. Simon Santoso in red, playing against Peter Gade, wearing a black shirt. This should be an exciting match with two different styles. Simon Santoso, who is more of a defensive player, while Peter Gade is very offensive. In spite of his 34-year-old, the Dane is actually peaking world number 4, while Simon Santoso is world number 9. And Peter Gade has won the toss. He will be the one serving. Of course, you'll have to realize that this is an exhibition match. No pressure, the players are here to enjoy themselves and to help the spectators to have a good time. Peter Gade, ready to serve. The spectators are already enjoying the show and participating.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Simon Santoso, Indonesia.
Simon Santoso, 24 years old. 10 years younger than his opponent.
On my left, Peter, Denmark.
Gade, very famous in Europe, in Switzerland. He's won here at the European Championships in 2004, so this is a place he knows very well. The hole was actually just next to this velodrome. This is an impressive first rally. This is an amazing rally, and it's out. Almost 1 minute for this first point. This is going to be a long night for Peter Gade. Were involved in the Yonex All England Championships just a few days ago. Peter. Peter is playing with a photographer. Yonex All England that was won by Lee Chong Wei. This shuttle is just out.
2-1
from Indonesia.
Peter is asking the line judge if he's from Indonesia. And then he's famous for his sense of humor. Yes! There we go, one big smash from Gade in the center. Obviously, the Dane does not want to give the shuttle to, to the service judge. A nice souvenir from the VIPs who are sitting just next to the court. This rally.
4-2.
You can see how precise these two shuttlers are at the net. It's out. Gade is not happy with the court. The line judges are in for a good time as well.
Three,
Simon might have a bit of difficulty to keep focus. Nice defense from the Dane. Two players have started this exhibition very fast. A lot of speed in the rallies. And the Dane is taking a lead. 6-3. Deceptive shot.
4-6.
Of course, the Dane is used to this type of exhibition matches. He's done many, many at home in Denmark. Yeah, that's a good one. He was waiting for that shuttle at the net, Peter Gade.
7-4.
And he now leads 7-4. Still serving low, very characteristic of the Dane's style. Amazing smash down the line, and then Gade, who is not able to retrieve it. He dived, but was not good enough. Simon has his spectators also cheering for him, and everyone is cheering for Gade. The Dane is playing around with the poor foot mopper. Santoso plays around also. Nice shot.
6-7.
Wow, that's amazing shot from Gade. Deception shot. Amazing rally, and it's in, right on the line. Simon was there, but he let it fall on the ground, and it hit the line.
8-6.
Now, who wants this shuttle? He has to warm up because the public is quite far from the court, and. Just outside. The Dane is amazing, playing around with the public. They tried to fool Simon Santoso and serve quickly while he was looking away, but unfortunately the shuttle was out. Very good atmosphere. Of course, the two players know each other by heart. They've played each other so many times. They respect each other. What a defense from Simon from his back. Good shot, and it's halftime. The Dane is leading 11-7. Oh, they're working quite hard, even if this is an exhibition match. A lot of high speed rallies. And the Dane is asking the line judge to bring him some air with his towels. You can see Hong Yen, who is talking. She was commentating on the player's strength, but Gade wanted some silence. Back in the game. 7-7, get it. You can see from the far end all the t-shirts that the players gave for auction, so that little bit of extra money is given to the foundation Solibad. That's the whole purpose of the evening, of course. This is something you would never see in a regular tournament. Peter playing and fooling around with the umpire.
Please play.
Nice net shot, and behind the leg. Another crazy rally from the two players, and it's out. Amazing rally, and Gade again sending the shuttle in the public. A lot of officials.
Sorry, Simon.
Peter Gade, the gentleman, offering the shuttle to one of the ladies around the court. From the Dane. 16-12. Right, on the men, Santoso. He's gonna have the mark of the shuttle on his hand or arm. Two big smashes from the Indonesian, but Gade, very good defense as well. Thank you. Allez. That's in. Amazing rally from the Danish player and the Indonesian, which ends in Gade's favour. And it's 5 points lead now for Gade. Oh, this time they got it. Finally, Gade is able to send the shuttle in the stands from this velodrome. Oh, nice match again. This time he's got the point, Santoso. As you know, these smashes go very, very fast, close to 300 kilometers per hour, with the world record held by Tan Boon Hong from Malaysia, 421 kilometers per hour. Record which was made in Tokyo last year. Gade on the ground. And Santoso is catching back. Good net play again. Another deceptive shot from Santoso. Out and Santoso is coming back. He was led by 5 points, and now only 2 points left for the Indonesian. He's fooling around too. What happened? Oh, he broke a string. 19-18. He is now in the lead. That's it. 2018, that's 2 game points, but this match is only 1 game long, which means that if Simon wins this rally, he will be the winner of the game and the match. Not for now, one saved, one to go. 19-20. Smash from Gade, and he saves his second match point. 20-all. serve smash from the Dane. Back to square one for Santoso. 20-all. Out. It's now a match point, forget it.
21-20.
Just barely outside the line. Right on Gade, one of the most difficult defenses to retrieve. The shuttle is on the man. Another match point for Santoso. Crazy match point. And Gade gets it. 21-all. He's going to get that one. One of the spectators next to the court. Now it's 22-21, forget it. Now he plays around with the cameraman. From Santoso. He was in the control of the rally and he ended up winning it. So it's all back to square one again. 22-all. Have amazing skills at the net. This smash is a bit short. That gives Peter Gade another match point, his fourth. Time for the public to cheer him up. For this time, another match point saved by the Indonesian.
23-all.
And it's now 23-all. Santos are waiting for the very last minute for this change of shuttle. From Indonesia, where one of Solibad project is going on in Bali. Care for Kids Bali, an orphanage in Bali, which has a project of computer science. And the ambassador for Indonesia is no other than Taufik Hidayat, who couldn't make it tonight in Geneva. he had planned to come, but last minute change. And Peter Gade, who hugs this line judge, who will probably remember this this evening for a long time. Now Tofik, who couldn't make it, but Simon is a bright replacement. Two of the best shuttlers on the planet for this night of charity. It's not over yet.
25-24.
And it's now Simon Santoso who is in the lead with a match point. Oh, they might be going all the way to 30, maybe. Of course, the public couldn't ask for more given the quality of play in this match. Big smash from Gade. The shuttle stays in the net.
26-25.
Point for Gade. Well, that's good again. Yeah, incredible. Incredible rally again. And Gade wins on this last point. What a night, what a match to remember for everyone here in Geneva. 1,000 spectators and Peter Gade gets away with the win. But of course, you understand that it is badminton, the real winner. High level of play, but the two players obviously enjoy themselves.
So you're gonna be in the Swiss Open soon.
Simon Santoso, who will be playing at the Wilson Swiss Open. That shows how generous these players are. They play this type of matches just before a major event, while Peter, he was just back from the All England.
You see how good Simon is. So it was a tough game. He got back and forth all the time. I think it was a really nice game. I think we've shown you guys how we play.
They sure did. They sure showed what kind of badminton the best players in the world can perform. Tonight, Peter and Simon played a great game. A lot of spectators actually never watched badminton before. A lot of officials from the United Nations, from the IOC, from other organizations in Geneva, and ambassadors, other officials. And a draw has been made, and some very lucky spectators were actually come on court to play with the stars. Names are being called. Four people have been drawn to play with Simon and Peter. One young player, two twins, and one man Those had to fill in and answer some questions online prior to this event, and they will have the luck to play with the stars. Here is the third lucky spectator coming on court. So he will be given the racket. Lucky chap. He will get to play with Peter's racket. Young left-hander from Geneva. The line judge. He probably knows that a lot of young people in the world would like to be in his shoes at this very moment. Playing Peter Gade is not very usual. Peter is a great player for this. He's able to entertain and play with the kids and perform. He is an entertainer as much as a player tonight. He took the time to come from Copenhagen, and he will be back to his family right after this. Not playing the Swiss Open, which means he came just for this event, a man with a big heart. And the whole public is now cheering for the young lad. He's gonna score this point. Nope. In the net. And Peter on the ground again.
Last one.
And one last point for Quentin. Good young player. He will be able to brag to his schoolmate that he played one of the best shuttlers ever. Great night to remember for this young kid. Shuttlers from the public were actually wearing skirts, so they were given badminton shoes. Cynthia and Laurie, who probably can't believe that they are coming onto a badminton court and who will be playing mixed doubles with Simon and Peter, the gentlemen. They will get to play with their players' rackets as well. Lucky girls.
Come on.
Peter is enjoying such a nice company. Nice souvenirs for the two girls coming just from the other side of the borders, the border from France. A lot of public has made the trip, only a few kilometers away from the French border, Geneva. This event was held and organized by the Badminton Club of Geneva, who has worked very hard to put up this show. Nice shot. Must be quite tough to play like this with Peter. Especially when he falls around and jokes all the time. Difficult to keep one's concentration. Ah, they have a good level of play. Probably badminton players. They will also be remembering this evening One Night with the Stars, but also with the local spectators. And Jean-Claude Varin, also from Geneva. Oh, he's pulling a trick on Peter Gade. Jean-Claude Varin. Oh, he's going to play with Peter Gade's racket as well. The speaker is saying that he has never played before, so he will get the help of Pi Hongyan. That must be nice to play with Peter Gade and have Pi Hongyan as a coach. The Dane has to explain the rule to Jean-Claude. Of course, not the same style of play. He's holding his racket like a pen, frying pan. But he will probably remember this evening as well. Pyongyang is giving some advices. It will work. Well, that works. He missed hit, but that looked much better. Well, that's good. That was amazing. But of course, you may have recognized him. He pulled a trick on Gade and the spectators. Jean-Claude Varin is no other than Hans Christian Vitthingus, number 3 from Denmark, who came here as well to play a trick on the public. And of course, he's played badminton before, you can see. Vitthingus, who has been supporting Solibad from the very start, wearing Solibad's logo on his shirt. Another great man, another great badminton player, even though he misses this shot. He's playing with his jeans, so maybe Taking his pants off. Well, he's putting on the show too, but it's only shorts. He will be back on court with the regular badminton kit. That would be much more comfortable. Dane has been showing a lot of progress lately on the world stage. Going to exchange a few shuttles with Peter, good friends, training together in Brøndby, national training center from Denmark. Good friends of court. And Vitthingus will also be playing in the Swiss Open just after this in Basel, some 2 hours or 3 hours by car. Yes. Grand Prix Gold event after being a Super Series for a few years. Ah. Oh, that's great badminton too. Very skillful. Of course, Peter Gade has just played a long match against Simon Santoso, so he might have a bit of a problem to cope with Vitthingus, who's just started. The public is cheering for Jean-Claude, of course. Having a ball too. Hans Kristian Vitthingus from Denmark.
Last one.
Two Danes, of course. Denmark is the European nation, the best nation on the European stage. Two champions from Denmark. Thank you for visiting Hans Kristian after putting a hat-trick on the fans, on the spectators. Good phrases. His coaching, of course, from playing with his left hand and then switching to the right one. And now, this first part of the show, we'll see some music with some local artists, Jeremy Kisling and Alan Coe.
Range ta chambre, mets de l'ordre dans tes repères. Sinon tu vas perdre le nord et perdre le sens des affaires.
Merci, au revoir, bonne soirée, merci. C'était Julien.
Going back on court, here are a few images of the Solibad projects and what has happened for the past year.
Yeah.
skater Gade will now show something exceptional. One of his most famous trick shots at the net, and whether could feed then Pi Hongyan. She's the global ambassador for Solibad, and she will be feeding Peter Gade with the shuttles, who is explaining that he will be performing two different trick shots, one from one side and one from the other side. You may have never seen this shot before. Pyongyang is feeding. Here we go. Oh, that's amazing. Look at that. He's taking the shuttle below his waist, pretending he's going to hit a net play. Oh, that's just amazing. Amazing play from Gade. One of his most famous trick shots he had performed in the final of the Copenhagen Masters against Pulela Gopichan. But this one you may have never seen. He's going to do it the other way, bending his wrists. This is a very, very, very difficult shot to perform. Oh, this is amazing. On his first attempt, Gade was able to put the shuttle on the other side of the net. This is just amazing. It usually takes 20 or 30 or even more attempts. And he's saying it, he can't do it better. This shot is very, very difficult to make. And he's done it again. He has done it again. Let's watch a replay of this amazing shot. Peter Gade. Here is now Nathan Robertson from England, who is going to do some of his secret shots, and he will be fed by Mr. Park Joo Bong. He is a legendary player from Korea, Olympic champion in 1996, and he was kind enough to come to this event. Look at Nathan. Behind the back, between the legs. Such a skillful player. Oh, that hurts. Whoa! Famous shot from a tennisman, French tennis player Yannick Noah. He used to do this shot between the legs. Here we go again. Well, they do that at training all the time. This one is good. Another showman, Nathan Robertson, very much involved with the Solibad from the very start. Look at him. Great English player. He can thank Mr. Park. And now we are back on court with men's doubles, something quite extraordinary. We have on court some of the finest shuttlers on the planet badminton. And a guest star. You may have recognized him in black, Mr. Park Joo-bong. He was an Olympic champion in 1996, and he's playing for the first time ever with his younger compatriot Lee Yong-dae. You have here two of the legends of Korea. Both Koreans playing together for the first time against Matthias Bø and Nathan Robertson. Matthias Bø has just won the All England, and Nathan Robertson is one of the best player ever. And this should be an amazing men's doubles. Matthias Bø is reminding the line judges how to make the calls. This should be a great match. Four amazing players. Europe against Asia. Denmark and England against Korea. Of course, Lee Yong-dae is half the age of Park Joo-bong. You can see Park is just an amazing player. He's now the head coach for Japan. Hasn't played for a long time. Competitive badminton. Very talkative players. A great first rally. And serving. He must be honored as well to play with such a legend. Park Joo-bong. Never, ever did these two players enter a court side by side. This is a world's first. Both Olympic champions, both in mixed doubles, only 20 years apart, 22 years apart. 2008 for Lee Yong-dae with her partner, with his partner, Lee Yo-jung. Yong-dae probably doesn't have too many opportunities to play matches like that either. Nice shot from Robertson down the middle. Fast. Yong-dae and Matthias Bø, who have played each other many times. Bø is world number one in men's doubles, and the Yong-dae with Jung Jae-soon is also in the top three. And Robertson at the net, joking around.
Oh, time! You're looking at me. Why are you looking at me? He's the one serving.
Oh, he's amazing. And he doesn't play badminton anymore.
Only
You're almost as old, Nathan. Come on.
Park Jumon coming at the net, asking for Yong Lee to take the attack. Yes, nice smash. And Park Jumon scores. Are taking the lead. Nathan is obviously enjoying himself. Great personality of court, Nathan. He has been one of the first ones to join Solibad as the ambassador for England. He was there for the press conference launch, and just before this event he sold all his old badminton kits from the Commonwealth Games, from the Olympics, where he had won the silver medal with Galems, and all the money went to Sparks and Solibad, more than €1,000. Very generous. And there goes one shuttle in the public. I can hear the whistle because he couldn't make it to the stands, just like Peter Gade earlier. What is he doing? That's better. Apparently there's a problem with the score. Nathan is not happy with the score. So it is 8-9. A bit of a change in the scoring. That could be the new scoring system. Players. Good defense from the Europeans. And it's just out. They must be enjoying this too. He probably saw Park Joo Bong on TV when he was a kid, looking up at this legend, and now he is side by side with him. Now he won't be fooled. No, He will not get fooled by Nathan. He knows better. Park Joo Bong. Another great man. Great player. Look at him. That's amazing. He's also playing around, showing his muscles, because he's got the shuttle right in the stands. And he was only a few hours ago on the top of the podium of the Yonex All England, winning his first title there. Congratulations to him and Carsten Morgensen. But still, he wanted to make it here to Geneva. He took the plane late in the evening from Birmingham to Copenhagen and then flew in right after to Geneva. Wouldn't want to miss this opportunity to play with Nathan Robertson against Yongde and Park Joo Bong. It's amazing how generous these badminton players, these stars of the game are. Taking the time out of their very busy schedule to come and play for charity. Energy drink to the line judges. Nathan is coming out of the court. Is now drinking while Matthias is doing the whole work. Yeah, he's got it. On his own, he beats Park Joo Bong and Lee Yong, but it is Nathan that gets the credit. What a great show from these players. Very nice shot. Park Joo Bong, you can tell he's been a great player and he hasn't lost any of his magic touch. Look at that. Backhand smash.
14-11.
What is he doing? He's punished. Nathan is taking the spot of the line judge. Now he's gonna remember this evening as well. Nathan is focusing on the line. Good shot. Now they will remember this match as well. Yongde and Park Joo Bong. I don't think they've ever lost a point against a line judge before. Now back. Nathan is back with the hat. He kept the hat.
Nathan!
amazing what they can do with their rackets. Matthias is now sitting on the lap of the service judge. And he's scoring! He is scoring on this last shot. Amazing, Nathan Robertson. What a rally. Amazing badminton play. This is quite unique in the world of badminton to see these four players. And now Lee Yong is trying to get the shuttle to the stands, but can't make it. Yes, it was.
Nathan! Matthias!
Yeah, yeah.
Again?
Yeah.
Again?
Yeah.
Mine?
Yes.
The English and the Dane are clearly enjoying each other. Showman Nathan is, and Matthias, great shuttlers, great performers and entertainers, as you can see tonight. What is he going to do now? Well, he gets a kiss. Oh, and she's got a racket! Now she will make some jealous people in the hall. This lady sitting next to Simon Santoso, she and the racket. Defense from the Yong Day in the back. He is also an amazing player, only 22 years old, already Olympic champion. He's going to be one of the best shuttlers all around. That was probably a fault.
One shot.
One shot.
Okay, it's a speed run now. What's up? Hey, Nathan!
Good shot again. Nathan at the net. That was probably What an unusual match to umpire for Arno Verdon on the chair, and Jürgen Pedersen, who was on the chair when Peter Gade and Simon Santoso were playing. They will remember this evening as well.
17-19. Ready? Ready, pass? Yes.
Matthias is sitting on the chair. Yes.
Okay.
And it's Park Ju Bong who scores finally. It's game and match point for the Koreans.
Charity. Give us a point, please. Yes! Charity.
19-20. We're not quite there yet.
19-20.
What are they discussing about? And that's it. Finished. Li Yongde finished this last point. This was an amazing game from these four shuttlers. Matthias Bo, he was the winner last night in the All England, and now back on court for charity, Nathan Robertson. Great, great English shuttlers. And Li Yongde and Park Ju Bong. A few words from the umpire. Of course, it was a big first for him. He said it was quite a tough to get focused, but it was just amazing to see these four players up close like this.
And we're so proud here to see you play. So it was really incredible. Thank you very, very much. It's so much for us to see you here. How do you feel today tonight? How was it for you?
Yes, I enjoyed playing today. So actually, we hired 1996, the National Olympics. After that, is today's champion match. We are here to enjoy and support this match. Thank you very much.
Bong Ju Bong, who mentioned he retired in 1996, but it sure didn't show tonight. He proved that he was still a great badminton player. This is it. That's it for tonight. Thank you for an amazing night of badminton. We hope you enjoyed the show. We surely did. We now will end this program with a song dedicated to Solibad from our friends from the Philippines, who are mobilized for our charity event tonight. And with the first badminton sound system, a musical performance by the DJ Paul, with the sounds made by local badminton stars Jeanine, Cicognini and Agnese Allegrini. A big thank you to the city of Geneva, the Badminton Club de Genève and the Badminton TV production. You can now join us for Solibad Day. This will be on the June of 5th for the world's biggest flash mob. Thank you again for joining us, and we hope to see you soon. Bye bye.
It's fun to be here. So there's a lot of spectators, so it's of course special to be here. It's a good event, so I'm glad to participate.
Well, for me, it's I always take every opportunity, you know, that I can to support projects like Solibad. This is only for good cause, and there's a lot of bad things going on around us in the world. So while we're playing on our circuit. For badminton, for competition, for beating each other. Once in a while, it's a good thing to stop up and look at the world and say, what can we do? And this is just a small thing, you know, and during the year, we can do different kind of events for Solibad. We're having fun, at the same time, we're helping people. That's quite a good thing.
The event's fantastic. The idea of, you know, Solibad, the foundation, is fantastic, that Raphael started almost 1.5 years ago now. So. And I wanted to be involved from the start, so, and try and raise as much money as possible. Recently raised £1,000 selling just some old Olympic and Commonwealth Games clothes for Solibad, and hopefully next year we can find a project in England to try and help some underprivileged children.
일단 솔리베드라는 게 좋은 일을 하려고 하는 것이기 때문에 저희 선수들도 이제 한 명 한 명 더 추가로 했으면 좋겠고 또 큰 거 하지 않고 그랬다고 제가 또 선수한테 잘 말하고 있기 때문에 앞으로도 좋은 선수도 나오게 되면은 여기에 참 많이 참여할 것 같습니다.
You know, like he's not only representing Korea, but he likes to, you know, be part of everything. But in Korea, what he likes to do is, you know, get all the badminton players involved, not only himself, but he wants to bring other players around and then make this thing really happen. But right now at this moment, you know, he's, you know, telling our other players to know what Solibad is all about. So I think we're in the situation that we're telling what is actual Solibad means. So we're starting with that, and then we're gonna work as a group, and then we're gonna go, you know, we cannot do like big thing at a time, but we're gonna go step by step, and we'll see how it works out.